build your own brand, develop your personality. Presenting specially structured short lessons on personality development and personal branding. If you enjoy our videos, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.
Hi everyone. I'm going to give a very important message in this. I read a quotation about carelessness. Overconfidence precedes carelessness. We have to be confident. Lack of confidence will not get you anything. At the same time, overconfidence will blind you to certain risks that you may go through. It's not how much you have planned. It's not how much you have worked. It's not how much sincere and hardworking you have been. It's not how meticulous you have been. It's not about how much skill you have got. But if you're careless, then you have a problem. Accidents, if you look at how they are caused, they will trace it to a small little action or inaction. And that action and that inaction could have been avoided if they had been a little careful. I want to tell you a story. It's about a person who was imprisoned for about more than 10 years. During the imprisonment, he read a lot of books. He wanted to improve himself. He regretted for what mistake he committed, what crime he committed. He wanted to turn a new leaf when he comes out. He knows if he has some special talent, a special skill, he can do well in the world. He did not commit any more crime. So he focused on one skill, one rare skill, and that is how to make ants speak. Ant, you know, A-N-T, ant. And he tried and tried and tried. He did a lot of research, years together in the prison. He will not speak to anybody. He and his research. One day, he was able to make an ant to speak. And a couple of more months, he perfected that. And that ant was really speaking. So the day for his release came, he shared his skill with the jail warden. They were all surprised. His inmates in the jail, they were surprised. And all of them said, "You are going to make a lot of money with this." And so he comes out from the prison, looks back, and he looks back at his hard work, days of work, days and nights of work in trying to learn this new skill. And he wanted to share it with somebody. He was not a great person. Nobody was there to receive him. So he was on his way home to share this talent to his wife, to his daughter, to his son, to his father and mother. He kept that ant in a small little matchbox, kept it safely in his pocket. On the way, he felt very tired. He wanted to drink something. So he saw a restaurant. He went there. He ordered to the server a cup of coffee. And as the server went to bring his order, he saw a cup of sugar and a spoon there. He was so excited about his aunt that was waiting to make him big. He thought for a while, "I'm going to have a coffee. This aunt, it's going to make me so big. Should I not give something to him?" So he takes out the small little aunt. There's a plate on his table. He opens this a matchbox, allows the ant to come out. He's so happy. He takes a spoon of sugar and feeds the ant. By the time the server comes, and he's so excited to tell somebody, so he wanted to share that happiness to that server. The server looked to his aunt, and this man said, "Sir, this aunt," and the server thought that this ant is irritated about this ant, and he just killed it and said, "Sorry, sir, this will not happen in this hotel again. All his hard work, all his sincere planning, all his curiosity, all his perseverance destroyed in a foolish act. You should have anticipated some wrong could happen. You know, in my career development program, I talk about unsafe act and unsafe conditions. I talk about crisis management. In every crisis, if you trace back one small little thing which was not done or which was done, this episode is meant for anybody, whether you are a student in a school or a college or an executive. Ask yourself, in the last 6 months, have you been careless? And if so, what were the result? What did you lose? Was it big? Take this lesson today. Overconfidence precedes carelessness. See you tomorrow.